When you're working with live SAP BW data that includes date dimensions and has virtual time hierarchies enabled, SAP Analytics Cloud lets you easily create time series forecasts based on your data and filter your data based on time ranges. In this video, SAP Analytics Cloud Global Product Evangelist Ingo Hilgefort shows you how it works.
Welcome to another video on the integration of SAP Analytics Cloud and BW. And this time we will take a look how we can leverage the time series chart forecasting and filtering. So we're going to create a new model based on a BW query. And in this case, the BW query does contain date characteristics such as the calendar day and the calendar month. So we quickly create the model, we save it, and then we're going to take a look at the list of dimensions. So as you can see in the list of dimensions, we have things like the calendar day, the calendar month, and the calendar year as part of the underlying BW query. So we're going to start building our story, and the first thing we're going to do is actually create a time series chart. So we're going to choose the model. In this case, we do have variables, but we can ignore them for now. So then we're going to choose our measure, which is the net value, and we're going to choose the calendar day as the dimension. We're also going to enable the time hierarchy. These are your virtual time hierarchies that you should enable for these kind of scenarios in BW. So in our case, we're going to use the year, the month, and the day as a hierarchy. We're then going to drill down in the chart. And we're going to switch the chart to a time series chart. So the time series chart gives us additional options, such as filtering based on, like, for example, 3 months or 6 months, 1 year, filtering basically the overall data set. And in addition, we also have the ability to actually do a forecast. To do this forecast, you do have to enable one of the options in the system administration to allow forecasting for live models. So make sure you actually configure that before you give this a try. So in this case, we'll actually have forecast after 2012. This is the data set we have right now. But you can see it basically would render a forecast as part of the time series chart. Another option that you can do as soon as you actually have date and time sensitive data coming from BW is actually filter on time ranges. So in our case, we have a table that shows the numbers broken down by country. And as you can see now, we build an input control and we offer the option to filter by member or by range. And we have a set of pre-configured periods. So for example, like the current year, the previous year. Those are only possible because we have the calendar day in the query. So for example, we can now create a dynamic time filter. And we can even include an input control that allows us to choose what the current date is. So for example, like a custom today. So we set the granularity to month and we start with January 2020. But we only have data for 2012, so we're going to have to adjust that. Based on the input date, we then want to see 3 months to the past and 3 months to the future. So we click OK, we confirm it, and then we're actually given two elements. We have the time filter, which you can see here on the right-hand side, and we also have a story filter, which is basically our custom today. And you can see the table has no data right now. But we do have the ability now to go actually back into 2012. And for example, choose like May 2012. And then May 2012 becomes our today. And now we're going to see the data for basically 3 months going back from May and 3 months to the front. In case you're interested in this, please take a look at the note that is mentioned here. And also make sure that the date dimensions are part of your BW query and that you enable the virtual date hierarchies in your BW system. I hope this information was helpful, and I want to say thank you for watching and listening.
Please subscribe to the SAP Analytics channel to keep up to date on this video series and other SAP Analytics Cloud content. See you next time!